Hey everyone, it's Colin here at etrailer, and today we have a 2019 Ram 2500, and we're going to go ahead and do a test fit of this Yakima HD Crossbar Roof Rack system. Now this has been designed to mount to the base roof of your Ram 2500, so you don't have any raised side rails or fixed mounting points or anything like that. It's just going to clamp on using your door jamb, and it's going to give you a really heavy duty roof rack to be able to load up your favorite rooftop accessories, whether you got a couple of bikes, maybe a kayak carrier, or even a cargo basket that you can load up cargo in that's going to help you conserve on space in the bed of your pickup and inside the cab. Now, like I said, this is a heavy duty roof rack that Yakima has made with these HD bars up top. These can actually support a load of up to 500 pounds. However, be sure to double check with your vehicle's owner's manual. I already know that that's going to be more weight than what the roof of your Ram can handle, so make sure you don't go over that specification in your owner's manual. With our baseline towers, these are going to have a weight capacity of 220 pounds, so you're already limited to be able to go up to that 500 pound weight capacity, but still, 220 pounds on your roof is a lot of weight. You're gonna be able to get a lot of stuff loaded up here, whether it's kayaks, cargo baskets, anything to that nature. The only thing I do wanna point out about these HD bars is that these have tie-down points on the ends of them. These give you a nice point to be able to secure whatever cargo you might have up there. Maybe you just got a paddleboard sitting on your roof rack and you wanna secure it. You can use those tie-down points to get those secured. Now, like I said, this is going to clamp under your door jamb right here. As you can see, we've got a pad and a rubber-coated hook that are right there. Let's go ahead and open up the door so you can see how it's attaching right now. So attached to our baseline tower, like I said, is that kit that is going to be designed for your Ram. Let's take this end cap off so you can see what's going on the inside. We have that hook coming up and securing into this bracket system right here. And then it just pulls up. When we tighten down this bolt, it pulls up against the door jamb and just clamps down on top of your roof. Then we have this rubber pad sitting on top of our roof that's going to help make sure it doesn't harm or scratch the finish of our Ram. And it's also going to provide a very secure connection. Now I'm gonna put the end cap back on, which is pretty easy to do. We also have these plastic locks, which we can replace with the Yakima same key system. That'll provide more security for your roof rack so no one can come up and remove it. Now this rubber strip up top can actually be removed to utilize T-slot accessories. What you do is just pull it out from this point right here. Just like that, you would cut it to length for whatever accessory you want to use, or you could just remove it altogether if you don't want to cut it. And then you just slide that accessory through the end cap right there into that desired location, tighten it down, and then you're good to go. Now I do want to give you guys a few measurements. First, from the top of our roof to the bottom of our crossbar, it's about 3 1/4 inches. That should be plenty of space to get any clamp-on accessories underneath your crossbar without risking damaging your roof. Now if we go from the top of the roof to the top of the crossbar, it's about 5 inches. That's something to keep in mind for any low clearance situations, that you have that added height to your roof. So maybe pulling in your garage or something like that, make sure that it'll clear before you try to pull in to your garage. And again, with the weight capacity, I wanna make sure you guys know, make sure that you don't go over any of the weight capacities for the baseline tower or your vehicle's roof. Use the lowest rating. Now that we've gone over some of those features, I'll show you guys how to get this installed. Now we've got the front crossbar already installed. It's gonna be the same process for the rear one. We'll go ahead and get it assembled on this table for you guys so you can better see what we're doing. I'm gonna flip my crossbar over just to make it easier in a little bit. Now down here we have our fit kit along with our baseline tower. What we need to do is get the baseline tower ready to go. We need to start with these two pieces that come with your HD bars. You're going to go into that top channel right there. You just need to kind of push down until it clicks into place. Like that. And get the front side too. Just like that. Now the silver piece right here is going to have threads on the inside, and it's going to go onto the screw that's in the middle right there. So we're just going to kind of line it up. And then in order to access that screw, we need to flip it over and actually pull out right here to uncover it right there in the center. With the included tool, we'll just start threading it on. You can kind of see how it's working right there. Now we don't want to go all the way, we just want to get the top edges of this silver piece lined up with our little black tabs on the end right there. We could probably go a little bit more. That should be good. Now with this pad, what we're gonna do is just put the bracket onto the piece right there. You wanna make sure the arrow is facing out away from the baseline tower. So just goes on like that, and we'll press it down on both sides so it's secure. Now we need to get that screw out of there so we can take the end cap off in order to get our baseline tower into that track. I'm just gonna turn it over so that it falls into my hand. There we go. Make sure you hold on to this so we can re-secure our end cap after. But all we're gonna do is just feed that piece into the channel. If it's a little tight at first, you may need to come back and loosen up that screw a little bit. Sometimes that'll help out. There we go, now it's in there. Now if you look closely, there's gonna be a set of numbers on the bottom of our HD bar. Now per our instructions, we need to move it to the measurement specified in the instructions, which is 46 1/4. So I'll move it up until the edge is touching 46 1/4. Just like that. And then we will tighten down that bolt all the way. That'll secure our baseline tower into the HD bar. Want to go until we hear those clicks. And we also want to make sure that our bolt right here is secured, which when it comes in, it should be already. Just like that. Let's go ahead and put our end cap back on. And our screw. And then from here, we're ready to throw it on our roof. Now make sure you got both of your rear doors open, and we're just going to climb up here and set it on our roof. Just needs to sit right there. Now what we need to do is grab our tape measure and measure our crossbar spread. Now what we're gonna do is measure center on center between the bars with the included tape that Yakima provides. And we need to make sure that it's 32 inches, which is the measurement specified in our instructions. Okay, exact 32. So we'll go to the other side and make sure that it's also 32. Now we can get our hooks installed. I'm gonna flip open that gray cap right there. And then all that's gonna happen with this hook is you're gonna slide it up in here until it hooks on, just like that. Now you can see that it's really up high off our roof right now. So what we're gonna do is come up to this bolt right here and then turn it clockwise, and you'll see that that hook starts going lower and lower towards the truck. We're just going to keep going until it makes contact. We don't want to over tighten it at all, so make contact, go one more turn, that'll be good right there. Now what we're going to do is tighten it up until it's flush on our door jamb, but we need to make sure we stop at that point. Just like that. Now what we need to do is repeat this for the other side, and then once we have that hook fully making contact with the door jamb, we'll rotate back and forth, going a couple turns on each side until it's fully secure. That's going to ensure that our roof rack sits center on our roof. It doesn't pull too much to one side. Now we've gone back and forth on both sides. Our driver's side is fully secured, so we're just gonna finish up over here. Once you hear those audible clicks that you also heard earlier when I was putting the roof rack together, it's gonna let you know that the tool has torqued it correctly. Now we can just shut our door, we'll put our end cap on, and from here, we're ready to load up our favorite rooftop accessories and then hit the road. Well everyone, that's gonna about do it for a look at the Yakima HD Crossbar Roof Rack System on our 2019 Ram 2500.